Hi, I'm Tom Hsu, and today I'm going to teach you how to sharpen eyes inside Photoshop. So the first thing I'm going to do, let's zoom in a little bit so we can see what's happening here. You notice that the exposure on the subject's face looks good, but the eyes may be just a little bit too dark inside the iris, the color information of the eye. We could duplicate the whole layer, but that would double the file size. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab the lasso tool, and I'm going to make a selection around the eye. Okay, then I'm going to hold down the shift key and I'm going to make a second selection. Notice the plus sign next to the lasso tool. Now I'm going to hit Control J or Command J on the Mac, and that's going to put all of that selection on a new layer. It didn't double the file size, so we're maintaining file size here. So with that layer selected, we only want to increase the brightness on that layer. We're going to go to Image, Adjustments, and go down to Highlight Shadows. Now you notice that it's going to increase how bright this area is of the eye. If you want a little bit less, you can back it off, but I'm not too worried about how much it applies here because I can kill this effect on the opacity slider in the layers. Okay, so now that we've got this done, I've got the detail in the eye the way I want it to look as far as color is concerned and brightness. Now I want to deal with the sharpness. So I'm going to duplicate the layer. I'm going to hit Control J, and that's Command J on the Mac. And let's zoom in a little bit so we can see what's going on exactly. Okay, that works. And with this layer selected, we're going to go to Filter. And what you might think you should do is grab Sharpen or Unsharp Mask, but we're going to go down to Other and choose High Pass. Now with High Pass selected, depending on the file size, the smaller the file will be the smaller radius you choose, and the larger file would be a larger radius you choose. So I work between 7 and 2, 7 and 4, depending on the file size. So I'm going to just bump this up a little bit, and I'm going to choose somewhere around 5. So we select OK, and now you notice that is all gray. We need to change the blend mode of this layer, and we're going to change it to overlay. Okay, now that we've got it to overlay, you can see that how much sharper that image is. Okay, so now we got the color information here and the sharpening information here. Let's hide it all and apply it selectively. To hide it, we're going to add a layer mask. If you hold down the Alt key, and that's the Option key on a Mac, it will hide that adjustment completely. Do the same thing with the color. Hold down the Alt key and the Option key on the Mac on that layer below, and now the color information is gone. So it's just a simple matter of fact of grabbing your brush tool, painting in the layer mask with the opposite color of what's there, which happens to be white we need to be painting with, and we can paint in the effect. Now, if you don't realize where you're painting and where you've missed, if you hit the backslash key, it will bring up the overlay for the mask. It looks like we're doing pretty good there. We made a good adjustment. And we'll come up here and we'll paint in the same sharpening detail just on the eye. Okay? And we'll check our adjustment. If we made a mistake, we'll hit the X key and we'll paint in black and we'll just pull off some of that adjustment. That's it. We'll hit the backslash key to get rid of the overlay, and now we'll make our final selection by choosing the opacity. How sharp do you want it or how bright do you want it? Okay, so we'll change our layer opacity for brightness and we'll bring it up to somewhere it looks normal, and you can see the difference between the sharpened and brightened and adjusted eye and the one that hasn't been. That's it. I want to thank you all for taking time to visit my blog today, and until next time, we'll see you soon.